I'm Lucy Porter. Within the last 6 years, I've had two children and lost both parents. So I recently became a middle-aged orphan. I felt like Oliver Twist, only instead of gruel, I wanted more Prosecco and Gogglebox. And like Oliver Twist, I fell in with a bad crowd, became a professional pickpocket, and was eventually taken in by a kindly older gentleman. My husband was livid. I started to think a lot about my relationship with the concept of family. If you're lucky, your family is a really great support network, a collection of people who will help you with anything you set out to do and always have your back. Unfortunately, none of my family could be here tonight. They all had pitiful excuses like, I'm busy, or I live in Ireland, or I'm only five and I have to go to school in the morning. Or, I'm not actually a member of your family, I'm Antonio Banderas. Please stop contacting me as per the conditions of the restraining order. Even my own husband couldn't make it. My husband, Justin, is a giant of the acting world, by which I mean he's 6'5" and he's been in Holby City. He said he had to stay in tonight because he's waiting for a call from the RSC. Not, as I thought, the Royal Shakespeare Company, but 1980s hip-hop collective, the Rocksteady Crew. Apparently, Normski's put his back out and they need a hype man for a gig next week in Rill. The Radio 4 audience not familiar with the concept of the hype man. So instead, to help me tell my story, I'm joined live tonight by someone who is practically family. It's the wonderful Luke Kempner! I first met Luke when he was 8 years old, and look at him now, all grown up. Oh. Luke, how's your mum?
Oh yeah, she's still not talking to you. And she's asked if she can have her slow cooker back.
Luke's here to help me with my mission tonight, which is to talk about the joy, despair, and general weirdness that is family life. I was raised in a nuclear family. If you start Googling nuclear family, it comes in the drop-down list just before nuclear fallout. And possibly with good reason. Both will keep you indoors a lot, eating cheap tinned food, and eventually both will kill you. A nuclear family used to mean a heterosexual married couple with 2.4 children. But these days, the term is extended to a variety of two-parent families, including step-parents, adoptive parents, same-sex parents. The birds and the bees talk is now a lot more complex.
When a mummy and a daddy love each other very much, they have a special cuddle. And, well, sometimes the daddy puts a baby in the mummy's tummy. Sometimes a mummy and a daddy go to a doctor and they take an egg out of mummy and the daddy gives a special cuddle to a cup. Sometimes a daddy and a daddy love each other very much, so they give a lady money so that she'll give a special cuddle to a turkey baster. Sometimes the mummy and the daddy don't love each other, they just met at a nightclub and didn't take precautions or one another's phone numbers when they had a special cuddle behind the bottle bank in the big Asda car park.
The only time you ever see a really traditional nuclear family these days is in adverts or on Peppa Pig. And even Peppa Pig's nothing like a real life family because they've got two preschool children and yet they're never seen watching Peppa Pig. So let's start telling my family story.
The beginning.
Let me take you back to the 1970s where my story begins in Croydon. I'll just get Luke to paint a picture for our overseas listeners.
Croydon, a sun-drenched medieval fishing village, widely regarded as the jewel in the crown of South London. Notable residents have included Dame Peggy Ashcroft and Stormzy. Local delicacies include chicken and bread.
Some years previously, my mum and dad, Morris and Rita, had decided to leave their own families and settle down in Croydon. If this was TV, I'd probably show you a picture of my parents, but being radio, I wanted to find something you could hear. One thing about growing up in the last century was that our childhoods weren't particularly well documented. We didn't make videos or take many photos. The camera only came out on holiday, and even then you only had 12 shots, most of which my dad used to take pictures of sunsets, seabirds, and that nice couple from Ormskirk we sat next to on the plane. So the only early recording of my parents I could find was this cassette tape of me playing the piano and my dad singing along. I think you'll agree, it's quite delightful.
holy child, how still you lie, safe the manger, soft the hay, faint upon the...
Such a nice bunch of people. You just kind of sat there kind of going, does she know it's awful? God bless him. My dad believed he was musical, in the same way that I believe I'm a tall, willowy blonde who lives in the south of France. My dad always claimed to have written the song Mull of Kintyre. Apparently, he was working in a shop in Liverpool and Paul McCartney came in while my dad was humming a tune he'd made up. Imagine my dad's surprise when some years later he heard that very tune at number one in the hit parade. It's a good job Macca didn't nick my dad's words for the lyrics too. It wouldn't have been quite so wistful if it had gone like this.
Two tins of peas, that's 55p, mate. Have you got the five? 'Cause I'm low on silvers. No worries, next, please.
Little extra information for you. Luke had to listen to Mull of Kintyre because he'd never heard it. Look, yeah, have you got a treat when the frog chorus comes your way? As you might have been able to tell from the clip, my dad was from Northern Ireland. This alerted me to the idea that all families are different. Other kids at school used to tease me, saying,
your dad's in the IRA! Your dad's in the IRA!
And I would reply very confidently, no, you're wrong. My granddad's in the IRA. Actually, my granddad was in the RUC, the Northern Irish Police Force, but I didn't understand when I was a kid because there were loads of acronyms connected to the Troubles.
These included the IRA, the RUC, the UDF, the UVF, and the OMG. That was the IRA's drag queen wing. They had really stunning balaclavas.
And to complicate matters even further, my dad's family was Catholic, and being Catholic in the RUC was like being a cat in a team of huskies, or like being the only vampire member of the Crucifix and Stake Whittlers Union. On my mum's side, there was great-uncle Billy, who was a builder. The legendary story about him was that he'd had a very successful construction business until he started drinking. Eventually, things got so bad that his wife left him, his children didn't speak to him, and he was living in his van. That was all he owned, his van and his ladders. One day, he hit rock bottom and he was down to his last few pennies. He went to the local pub and spent the remainder of his money on one final pint. He didn't know what he was going to do next, and as he drained his pint glass and put it down on the table, a shaft of sunlight came through the pub window. And this shaft of sunlight passed through the cross on the spire of the church outside and projected the perfect image of the cross onto the table in front of him. And Uncle Billy saw the cross and made a decision. He went back, got his van and his ladders, and went up on the church roof and nicked the lead. He sold it, came back and bought a round for everyone in the pub. That's my family, drunk but generous. Apart from that, I thought my immediate family was pretty dull, save the fact that my dad wrote Mull of Kintyre. And I'm ashamed to say that once I hit my teens, I was just desperate to get out of suburbia. This took me to the next stage of my journey through family life.
Leaving the nest.
A lot of people spend their 20s away from their old family units, trying to start anew and make a sort of family out of friends, romantic partners and housemates. I left home in the 1990s when the TV show Friends was a template for our generation and we thought it was really cool. But even the friends in Friends had a definite mum figure in Monica, and Chandler was a sort of silly dad. Rachel, Joey and Phoebe were the kooky kids, and Ross was the uncle that nobody likes.
Hey, who likes dinosaurs? I like dinosaurs. Let me tell you my top 100 dinosaur facts after I've told you about the misery of my last divorce.
Is that one of your impressions?
Yes.
Yeah, who was it meant to be?
It was Ross from Friends. Thank you. One person.
That's your mum. When you start moving away from the family unit you grew up in and replacing them with friends, it's an important moment because that's when you realise just how weird your own family was. For example, my mum was such a fan of not making a fuss.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.